Dominique et Nick et Nick s'en allaient tout simplement. Routier, pauvre et chantant. En tout chemin, en tout lieu, il ne parle que du bon Dieu. Il ne parle que du bon Dieu.
À l'époque où Jean sans terre d'Angleterre était le roi, Dominique, notre père, combattit les albigeois.
Dominique, Nick, Nick s'en allait tout simplement, routier, pauvre et chantant. En tout chemin, en tout lieu, il ne parle que du bon Dieu, il ne parle que du bon Dieu.
Certains jours, un hérétique par des ronces le conduit, mais notre père Dominique par sa...
They're not really like us. The dress is one of the key signifiers of this purity. It's not just sexual purity, it's biological purity. I mean, it's this higher form of being. I think people know that, and that's why that symbol is powerful.
This not quite human status has made it easy to completely remove nuns from their interesting and important stories and allow their images, almost always in full habit, to be used by anyone who thinks they can profit by sticking it on their product. They are encased in soap, shot out of toy guns, and literally bowled down. You can wipe your mouth or blow your nose with them.
Today, I think that the figure of the nun resides mostly in the realm of kitsch. What I mean by kitsch is they have become icons without history. There seems to be no meaning, no reason, no rationale, no context for their image and the use of their image, which is completely arbitrary. You know, it's meant to be funny, and it often is, but why? We don't know anymore. The nun is an object of values and meanings that we have nostalgic appreciation for, but no longer consider of any social or economic value in contemporary settings. And so they either get appropriated through nostalgia and sentimentality, or ironically as kitsch. Either way, they're kitsch.
But there are people who know nuns beyond the realm of kitsch, know them as women who are not only fully human, but whose lives are vibrant and interesting. Women who, even when they seem to look alike because of their habits, were both individuals and members of groups which had profound understanding of their mission and who sustained that mission through community. And there are times when popular culture tries to tell these stories, particularly in narrative formats which allow for character development and complex relationships. Among the best known and most highly regarded are The Bells of St. Mary's, The Nun's Story, Lilies of the Field, The Trouble with Angels, Dead Man Walking, Doubt, the HBO series Oz, and the short-lived television series Nothing Sacred. Comedies as well as dramas tackled the intricacies of religious women's lives.
Oh, come on, we can do a little better than that. Let's try that again. Good evening, class.
Good evening, sister.
Very good, very good. Now, before we begin...
Late Night Catechism is a one-woman play that started in Chicago in 1993 and has been performed throughout the world. It features a nun in a habit familiar to Catholic baby boomers who treats the audience as though they were in her class, questioning, correcting, cajoling, and even punishing. Among its many achievements is raising well over $2 million for the welfare of actual women religious.
The reason nuns love our show is because our character is not a silly, dancing, joke-telling caricature. We have a real character. That's very different. And our nun is very true to her religion. She's true to her calling. She's educated. She expects you to be educated. She expects you to answer questions correctly. And that's exactly what a nun would do.
Thank you there, cleavage girl. Cover up.